David Martin in the Breitling 232. Come on, make some noise.
How many of you think the airplane's going to win? How many of you think the jet truck's going to win the race? Oh, come on, Houston, help us out here. How many of you think the airplane will win the race?
There we go.
How many of you think the jet truck will win the race?
I think it's about 50-50.
Pretty
all
much
right, so
even.
No odds. I was going to give some odds if it was skewed one way or the other, but clearly wrong. We have a split crowd here. They're sort of like the Texans and the Cowboys playing in a football game. Not too sure who to root for, but here we go. I'm going to let you make the call. All my money, every bit of it, is on David Martin in that Breitling 232.
Out on the line there as Chris Darnell puts it into position. Wayne Rachel, his crew chief, is going to go out there, take one final look at the truck, make sure everything's all right, and they'll get on the radio and David will start his diving pass. I think we're going to wait just a couple of seconds to get some of this smoke out of the way because the shockwave created its own weather system out there.
Here we go! On your feet, Houston! Here it comes! The race of the century! Airplane versus jet truck! Who's going to win?
Accelerating now through 100, 125, 150, 175, 2, 225, 342, 342 miles per hour, and then let him out. Ladies and gentlemen, I think we had a winner in the jet truck. 7,000 pounds of absolute Houston power. Let's give a big round of applause at 342.6 miles per hour. Chris Darnell, and sorry about David Martin. I think he could have put a little more smash in on the dive-in.
Oh, it was a great race, but like you said, with over 7,000 horsepower, it's tough to beat. All right, Houston, coming up next, I'm going to turn it back to Rob Ryder. It's your U.S. Navy Blue Angels. It's been my pleasure to be your co-host very briefly for David Martin in the Cap 232, brought to you by Breitling. Enjoy the rest of the afternoon, Ellington Field!